Haiti is the world's first black independent country. Our Independence Day was on January 1st, 1804. It is always an honor for every Haitian to cook soup jumu on New Year's Day. This tradition is a symbol of unity and freedom. Also, it was forbidden by their French masters for Haitian people to eat soup jumu. So since they won the independence, then their first meal was to have soup jumu. It is such an honor for me today to show you how to make this delicious dish. First, you will need lots of meat. You will need, my preference is beef and with some bones. And the bony part, it gives the stew a uncomparable flavor. So now you need a lot of stuff. So you have to be in the cooking mode to be making soup jumu. So here I have the beef here, and this is what I'm talking about, with the bony part, because it gives it a very nice, the bone marrow when it's when you put that in the stew. It has some meat, but it's mostly it has lots of bone too. All right, so this you need the neck bone, so that's how you will you'll find most of the bony part. All right, so then you need Canadian, that's to season the meat. You need Canadian steak or seasoning or any other seasoning that you have. You need cloves, you need cayenne pepper, and I'm gonna also use this here, complete seasoning. And another very important ingredient is nutmeg. All right, so next we need tomato, green bell pepper, Maggi, pure vegetable oil, this is cilantro, parsley, lime, garlic, scotch pepper, and also scallions, no, shallots, sweet onions. We call it sweet onions, we call it a shallot. All right, oops, dropping things. And this is turnips and carrots. Also we need onions and macaroni. I prefer this kind. Also you need scallions, I think. I can't remember. Anyways, I can't even remember it in Creole. All right, and then this is celery. All right, let's see. And on this side here, we have cabbage, we have potatoes, and we have squash. So I have this acorn squash, or you can use the butternut squash. All right, and I have some more meat here. This one is I put this one is meat. It has lots of meat, so this one has no bone at all. So I just soak put this one in some vinegar and some salt. All right, and I also have this bread. It's called, well, pain baguette. It's really, really good, and it's very easy to make. Here. So you just put this, preheat. That's the baking instruction. And it's gonna taste very, very good with this. Alright. Or if you have Haitian bread, it will be even better. So, alright. So, on the next step, I'm gonna show you guys. So, I have to get to work right now. And it takes a long time. Oh, and I almost forgot. You need malanga. Make sure you don't confuse this with yuca. It's not yuca. It's called malanga. M-A-L-A-N-G-A. All right.